Hello, my name is Enrique Larios Vargas, and today, on behalf of my co-authors, Maurício, Christoph, Magiel, and Georgios, I will present our paper, Selecting Third-Party Libraries, the Practitioner's Perspective. This study has been done in collaboration with Software Improvement Group and TU Delft in the Netherlands, and the University of Adelaide in Australia. The selection of software libraries is a recurrent practice among software practitioners. When we explore this problem, we need to understand actually different roles that are involved in this selection process. From one side are the users, who are the software teams, who continuously adopt software libraries to their projects. And in the other side, we have the library or technologies providers, who are continuously managing the evolution of the software libraries, introducing new features, fixing bugs, and managing in general the evolution of these technologies. So as researchers, we identify that there is a lot of problems regarding the difficulty for practitioners to select libraries. What are these problems? In our study, we have identified the following challenges. First, the landscape of technologies is continuously overgrowing. So that makes even more complex the selection of libraries for practitioners. Second, the adoption of the right library is a demanding task. This situation can happen in any part of the lifespan of a software project. In a third place, the number of factors that should be taken into account during the selection process is significant. There are so many factors taken into account, and we are not aware at the moment of the decision of which factors or which criteria should be more important than others. And in the last challenge is the lack of systematic process for library selection. We have observed that there is an ad hoc process when the selection of software libraries happens in practice. So we want to know exactly what kind of guidelines or heuristics practitioners follow to understand better how this selection of third-party software libraries happens in practice. For that reason, we want to explore what are the factors that influence the library selection. Our study design consists of four different stages. First, we conducted semi-structured interviews. 16 practitioners were interviewed. They are coming from 11 different companies, 9 different fields, and in general between 4 and 15 years of experience. Then, with all this qualitative data collected, we transcribe all the interviews, we perform an open coding, and then we build a factor book. This factor book was refined after discussions, in many discussions with other co-authors, until we reach a factors book, a final draft. Then, to validate our factors book, we conducted member checking sessions. In that way, we ended up with 26 factors that practitioners found more influential for the selection of libraries. To challenge our factors book and these 26 factors, so what we did is to conduct a survey. So we had 115 respondents in this survey, and we could identify what was the level of influence of these 26 factors as perceived by our respondents in the survey. What we got is that factors influencing the selection process can be categorized in three different aspects: technical, economic, and human. To go in more detail a little bit regarding the technical factors, we had, in the case of functionality, for example, the fit for purpose and the size and complexity. As you can perceive in the bars, that represents how is the level of influence according to our survey respondents. You can see that the first bar corresponds to no influence, the second one to low influence, the third one to medium influence, the fourth one to high influence, and the last bar represents not applicable. So in this case, we can see that interviewees and respondents from the survey agree in general that functionality is one of the core aspects when they have to decide for which library to adopt. Definitely fit for purpose and size and complexity are quite important. But regarding the released, for example, most of them agree that maturity and stability and active maintenance should be factors that are quite relevant in the selection process. As well in the regarding quality aspects, like usability, documentation, security, performance, alignment with architecture, and if it is well tested. One thing to highlight here is that the aspect of software system makes the difference. In this case, to have a brown or greenfield project limits or gives you more freedom in the decision space for selecting a library. In the case of a greenfield project, for example, it's a project where you start from scratch, so there is no limitations in the selection of libraries. In case of a brownfield project, so you are limited to the technology stack that has been already decided and guides the software architecture of the product. In the case of the human factors, we have individual, in this case, the perception of the practitioner regarding this library. It is possible that this practitioner already have some experience using this library, so this his self-perception or her self-perception works an important role during the decision. But as well, sometimes you need influence or you need to information regarding the library from external people, in this case from your immediate community. It can be, when we are talking about community, it can be not only the people who are behind the library providing support, but also the community who are using the library. So in this case, popularity is one of the aspects taken into account that is quite relevant for practitioners, but also in this case, how is the experience of these people using the library. So the information that they provide in technical blogs, for example, is important to have a feeling of the experience of this library satisfies their expectations or not. And also the activeness of the community. So how easy is to reach this community behind the library? Are they active providing support, fixing bugs? So that's quite important as well. And both our respondents from the survey and the interviewees agree in these influential factors. In the case of the organizational ones, there is a huge difference. Most of these organizational factors came up from the interviewees, but people from the respondents from the survey, they don't agree at all with them. So for instance, the type of industry, culture and policies, and management and strategy were factors that were mentioned in our interviews. The type of industry, for example, is important for our interviewees because sometimes they mentioned that when you build, when you develop software for a certain type of industry, like financial organizations, is totally different process when, or take or factors that you usually take into account in the development than if you develop software for other type of businesses. That doesn't require a very strict policies or process in the development. And also sometimes the management and the strategy plays a role as well, as our interviewees mentioned sometimes that there are some tendency to adopt or to have some agreements of cooperations with the specific providers. Regarding the stakeholders, definitely the development team is plays a crucial role in the decision making, but there is a big difference regarding the option of the customers. For our interviewees, customers play a role sometimes, especially if they are involved in some technical decisions. In regarding other teams, depending on the type of project as well, there is sometimes other teams like are in charge of the security aspects of the library or the legal aspects of the library that they need, they make the final decision. Or sometimes there are some other aspects of the that are not necessarily technical, but there are hidden information about the cost or maintenance or economic aspects that are information provided by the project or the product managers that usually the software team are not aware of. And finally, we have the economic factors. In this case, the risk. Sometimes the need to evaluate what is the impact of adopting a library is important for many of our practitioners. As you can see, both our interviewees and, in this case, our respondents in the survey agree in this aspect. Especially because when the output of this risk assessment provides information if the library can be adopted or, in this case, can be, depending on how crucial or how important is the library in the software architecture, maybe an option is to have a paid version or enterprise edition of the library, or to have the rights to do any fix in the source code, or just outsource the development of the library, or just develop the feature by themselves. Any other aspect, we have the total cost of ownership. In this case, the time and budget and the license is really important. Regarding the role of the factors in the selection, one important thing that we have identified in our study is that not all the factors play a crucial role at the same time. So if we want to separate, let's say, in a timeline, or what is the role of these factors in the selection process, we can identify two different stages. The first one is the upfront stage, and the second is the prototyping stage. In the first stage, the aim is to have which are the potential candidates that can be adopted in the end. But in this case, in the upfront stage, is more exploratory part of this process. In this case, the first impression of the library matters. Is it a good first impression? So that means that there is a potential candidate for my selection. So what kind of factors can be used at this stage? Well, practitioners mentioned that there are also a mixture of technical, economic, and human factors involved here. But for example, within the technical factors, okay, a first good impression of a library is, for example, if it is mature enough, has a good stability, if at least there is documentation, that is a good sign of quality, and if there is an active maintenance of the library. So at least they have the impression that the project is still alive. In another situation, we have also economic factors. For instance, the license. The license needs to match what they expect from the library for the final use of the library. So it's really important. Sometimes it's even a strong blocker if the library doesn't match the purpose of the software. So definitely it limits the adoption. And the time and budget plays a crucial role here because that probably can force them to evaluate if they need to invest time and money in the development of their own library or not. Sometimes, depending on the type of industry, so the amount of libraries also are very small, so they need to make this evaluation. Regarding the human factors, if the practitioner doesn't have the experience having used this library before for this required feature, so that means that the practitioner needs to reach their immediate community. In this case, it can be a community of practice, or just searching for information in a Stack Overflow or modern aggregators like Reddit or technical blogs specialized in this kind of information. And they collect information about how the community, in this case people, have experienced the use of these type of libraries. So that kind of information provides them with a good impression if this is a good candidate or not. So at this stage, we just have potential candidates. Then in the next stage is the prototyping stage. So this is the stage where they are trying these candidates out. So and in this case, other factors play a crucial role here. So once we have the candidates, we are trying them out. So we are evaluating more specifically certain features or certain characteristics of the library. For example, the usability. Is easy to use? Is it intuitive? Or is the documentation good enough so I can work with the library properly? The quality of the documentation plays here a role. In the first stage, for example, the presence of documentation was important. But here, now that they are trying them out, so it's important that the quality of the documentation be good enough, I mean, for making this kind of prototype. In some cases, for example, this type of prototypes needs to be a working prototype. So the documentation should support this process. So performance as well and security are taken into account here, because definitely when you are trying the library, now you can have access to the source code, and then you are checking how the library is managing probably sensitive information, or what kind of communication protocols are using. That's more diving in the technicalities of the library. But obviously, human factors and economic factors also have an influential, in this case, in the selection process, because the knowledge of your community plays a role here. When we get feedback from the community, that helps practitioners to make the final decision. A risk assessment, time and budget also have a presence here, because if after trying them, and you find a lot of problems regarding security, performance, or quality in general, so that force in some way to start evaluating the possibility to adopt a paid version of the library, or in this case, develop the feature by themselves. Our study have the following implications. The implications for academia. Our study expose what kind of information practitioners need when they select software libraries. And this is important because time plays a crucial role here. We have to give them at the right time the information about the factors, the characteristics that the library has, or the version of that library has at that moment, so because that information is relevant at the moment of the decision. Libraries evolve fastly, and the adoption of a library in this case, and to have up-to-date information of how this evolution is going, is really important for practitioners. So that also push forward the need for have appropriate tools for having near real-time driven feedback information. Our study also highlights that it's important to have empirical guidelines. In this case, this kind of studies highlight not only regarding the information needs, but also in how we can improve or make more systematic, in this case, any process in this case regarding the decision making in software development. The API providers are managing continuously the evolution, in this case, of the library, because they are introducing new features and fixing and generating new versions. So that means that they need to take into account, because they also invest time, money in the development of these products, in these APIs. So if they want to make them this project sustainable, so they need to take into account what are the factors that, in this case, the practitioners take into account when they select or adopt their products. So our study also highlights the need for modern package managers, because almost all practitioners, they reach the package managers at a certain point to collect data regarding some technical aspects of the library. But package managers usually are used only for managing the different versions and the dependencies of the library in the software projects. But in this case, these package managers can evolve because they can become a single point of decision. They can have all these information needs, let's say at the moment of the decision making for selecting a library, they can have this information, and instead of having this dispersed data regarding the factors or that are required by decision makers, so they can hold this information and facilitate that decision for practitioners. In our study also, we provide some suggestions or recommendations for software practitioners. Lacking a way of a checklist, is important for them to take into account these criteria, especially because if we want to make these decisions more systematic, at least we have to ensure that we have follow at least some of the best practices, in this case, from the industry. to take into account the experience of using the library, take into account not only popularity, that is sometimes is probably one of the most common aspects in the decision making, but to take into account other aspects of the library as well, like the how active is the community, how responsive is that community, how mature and stable is the library, how good is the documentation that the library holds, and is it well maintained, does the library have an appropriate license, so and budget, and also and time, are they constraints in my project? So these kind of factors should be taken into account all the time. In our study, finally, we, as conclusions, we have explored all the factors influencing the selection process, from the technical aspects, economic and human aspects. We provided as well how these factors play a crucial role during the selection process in different stages, in an upfront stage and in the prototyping stage. And also we have provided implications for academia as a future work, and also for library providers as well as for practitioners. Thank you very much for your attention. If you can find more details in our paper, and if you have any questions, don't hesitate to let us know or to ask me by email. Thanks.